Hey everybody, Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a LEGO Hero Factory promotional polybag set from Invasion From Below Wave 2. This has 28 pieces and I don't know the name of it. Truth be told, I don't have this set. I saw it announced on the front page of my favorite LEGO site, BrickSet.com, yesterday and immediately went and built it out of parts that I already had because they don't introduce any new pieces with this. It was shown there as a promotional set in Russia. If you purchase above a certain amount in LEGO stores there, you would get this for free. That's a pretty good deal. I mean, free is free. And for how few pieces it has, 28 pieces, it has six transparent light blue pieces, which is great, especially considering that four of them are the same bone piece. They're the really short one. But this is great for mock makers. If you can get, you know, hopefully this will become more widely distributed and widely available, possibly even available just for regular purchase by itself for, you know, $5-6. From past experience, I'd say they would probably try to sell this for $8, which is probably too much, but hopefully enough of them will get out there on the market and secondhand you'll be able to get these pretty easily. It has the head of Crystal Beast with just a different horn on the top. You see they use the same large barb or medium curved barb piece here, a couple of them back here, and then one on each of the front little legs there. This piece in the middle is just to help hold it up, I think, for play. I think they were trying to add a little bit of extra structural stability to the thing because, I don't know, I guess the way that the legs are angled out makes it easy to compress the thing down, but I really don't like that piece, of course. Beauty of the system is you can just pop it right off. So simple, looks much better like that, I think. And this, you know, as a beast, yeah, it's small, but I think it fits in well with the other beasts, even against a full-sized crystal beast. Because of the color scheme in here, I think it just looks like a good little massable unit, something that would be a step up from a jumper. Of course, this jumper is included. It's not from Wave 2, it's from Wave 1 with the black carapace. But just imagine an adventure with the Hero Factory heroes going down into the tunnels. And at first they're dealing with lots of jumpers. It's just, you know, the little kind of random peon unit, if you will, that can just easily be dispatched. But there are just lots of them, so they kind of harass you. And then you move into another section and it's kind of like an upgrade. You move from dealing with jumpers to dealing with these instead, and lots of them. So you really have a proper challenge. I think that would be kind of a cool way of looking at this. The head is able to just move down and up a little bit. And of course, you've got a joint on each of these, actually a pair of joints, but a bone piece on each of the legs. So you can do anything that you can think of with a regular leg. The weight of the thing is mostly in the head, just because it's such a large piece, but you can still kind of lean it back, move this rear corner leg forward, and then you just get a single leg up like that. So I think it's pretty cool, and you know, for it to be free, of course, can't really complain about anything about it. And again, hopefully this will become easier to get in the future so more of us can get our hands on these for cheap and get the parts or just get the whole beast. So that's it for this video. If you have any thoughts about this set, please do post them up, share your thoughts with the rest of the viewing community. Also, if you hear about an official name for this set, please let that be known in a comment. That would be interesting to read about. Always good to get more info about obscure little sets. But that's it for this video for now. Thanks again for watching. Talk to you again soon.